So now this is where I went to middle school, Level View Middle School. So I was a Level View idol. I came here in fifth grade, so you started in fifth grade, sixth grade, seventh grade, eighth grade. Had awesome times here. I kind of came out of my shell. Sixth grade, I came out of my shell a little bit, but I was, it seemed like I was kind of a jealous time. I mean, some of my best friends were hands down the most popular people in school and out here at Level View. And so, and I was like best friends with them, so I got a little jealous a little bit, it seemed like. Eighth grade is when I really came out of my shell. I sang in choir here. I also tried out for the football team, but I must say I wimped out. And much to people's surprise, they knew I could play. I was QB mainly, right? But much to their surprise, when I tried out, I was beaten. I was competing for the starting job as QB, and everybody was kind of surprised and in shock. But then I wimped out because of the, I remember one exercise in particular called the camelback or something like that, where you had to lay down flat on your back and put your helmet on the ground and arch your back up or something, man. And I was like, ooh, and it was so hot with the football pads on and all that. Played softball over here on this field. Well, back that way. Back behind there, we had a lot of recess time and stuff, which I've taken you guys back that way. So a lot of good times here. I went to traveling choir competitions with the school and stuff, and we placed first in pretty much everything we did. It's a lot of fun times. And yeah, I was still dreaming about coaching basketball, living in LA, all that stuff, and when I was out here. High dreams, high expectations of myself. But I remember that there was a teacher named Miss Yogalette, and sometimes people would call her Yogi. And here's a story about it. Everybody's acting up. There was utter chaos in our class. Nobody listened to her. It was just utter chaos, and they made fun of her. So me, being innocent, I was just like, gee whiz, man, people's gonna get us in trouble. We'd have to write out sentences, we won't talk, and even if we weren't involved, she'd have the whole class. Well, she takes a buddy of mine, and he was a big goof off troublemaker. Well, not a troublemaker, he just liked that fun. But he was known for his little shenanigans in school, let me tell you. It was crazy. Well, he took an eraser and spelled out on the chalkboard the F word, F-U. And so she turns around, it was one of those days everybody's gonna get it. She turns around and he blames it on me. She's like, who did it? And he blames it on me. It was horrible. So I got sent down to the office. The principal that I loved, he wasn't in the office. I was like, oh, great. So the assistant principal, who I didn't hate, but he was, I wasn't in good with him like I was the principal. And he's like, well, we're going to whoop you with a paddle. I was like, oh, no, I've never been whooped by a paddle. What do you think happens? Just in time, the principal comes in. He liked me, and he says, nope, we'll just gonna put you in ISS for 3 days. So I lucked out there. I did not write that on the chalkboard. I mean, that was crazy. But that's the stuff you could do with her. You could sneak behind her back and do all kinds of stuff. She wouldn't catch it. It's just unbelievable. Then you could blame it on anybody. Another story. I cut my thumb here in eighth grade in woods. I slit it. Had to get 3 stitches, but I was the only one, one of the only ones in eighth grade that could use a radio arm saw. and it was Woods, I think, is what class it was. And I'm not good. I'm not mechanically inclined. I'm not good with my hands or anything, but I was trustworthy, and I could do that. And so I cut a lot of people's wood out all semester, and I kind of put my projects on the backbone, which was okay. So then the week before the last day of class, you know, I had to buzz through all this stuff and cut it all up. Well, I accidentally cut my thumb because I was in a hurry because I wanted to get my stuff done. And I left a blood trail through the school, and everybody knew I was the talk of the school. And, but anyway, Mr. Fitzgerald was his name, the Woods teacher. And everybody would call him Gargamel, and if you did that, you was in deep trouble. But he was kind of like Miss Yogalette. But he took my thumb, big guy, huge guy, took my thumb and just squeezed it. Then another situation with Mr. Fitzgerald, same thing happened like as in Miss Yogalette's class, the same guy too. He joked around with Mr. Fitzgerald and he yelled Gargamel. Well, Mr. Fitzgerald's like, who did it? Well, my friend, it's the same friend as Miss Yogalette's class, said Joe did it. I'm like, no, I didn't. So he pulls me out of the class, and he's about where I whoop me. I'm like, oh yeah, this is just great. Well, the Woods teacher, Mr. Seifelein was his name, huge guy. I just loved him to death. Awesome guy. Huge. I think he was an Olympian or something. No joke, he'd do one-arm push-ups. That ain't no joke. But he seen me, and he said, well, what did he do, you know, to me? What did he do? And I said, heck, I didn't do nothing. And Mr. Fitzgerald, and he was about to whoop me at the paddle. I was like, no. And so Mr. Seifelein said, well, hey, guess what? He said, Joe, you're going to come with me. I was like, yeah. He told Mr. Fitzgerald he has me and everything will be taken care of. And he took me, and I think I spent the day in the wood shop helping cut wood and stuff like that. So he didn't, I don't know. So I never got paddled one time in school. It's because I lucked out. Actually, when I was going to get paddled, I shouldn't have anyway. But every time I was, I got saved. So I never got paddled one time. But that was just, that's some of the middle school stuff. I miss the school so much. I loved going here. Oh, okay. Also, as a student here, we got a thing called histoplasmosis, and it's a disease. And somehow, bolts waste got into the ventilation system or something. I don't know. I still don't understand what happened, but everybody, there's a lot of people who got histoplasmosis here at Livelview. And this is way back. I think it even made national news. But we all got tested. Everybody was missing, sick. There was a secretary that passed away, unfortunately. It was just a big crisis here, and we ended up getting sent back. I think it was my fifth grade year, and I left Hurlsman at fourth grade. I mean, you know, after fourth grade, you came here in fifth. And what happened is we ended up getting sent back to Hurlsman because they closed it down because they considered it unsafe. And so, anyway, I remember getting blood tested all the time, constantly getting my arms poked and everything, and I wasn't sick. I was so blessed and fortunate I never got sick, thank God, that I know of. You know, I might have got a little sick and blamed it on that, I don't know, you know, and just didn't know it, but maybe it was part of it. So we didn't get our results, me and a group of my other friends, we didn't get our results of the test until that summer. And sure enough, it came back positive. Me and all my friends, we all had it. However, I think all cases were so mild that I don't think it's that big of a deal. I don't know. I've never had an issue, thank God. That's how middle school went, and I'm ready to go to high school. Are you ready for high school? Eighth grade year was one of the best years of my life, too. My last year here, awesome time. So let's go to high school.